Assalamu alaikum. Many years back, I was in my duty room and was accompanied by one of my colleague who was from a Muslim country. I had read about Piltdown Man little back then, so I wanted to discuss this with her. I wanted to know whether she was taught about Darwinism in her country, and if she was taught Darwinism, what was the manner it was presented to them. She kept on avoiding the discussion and changed the topic many a times before I directly questioned her about her country's curriculum on Darwinism and about her opinions in this regard. She said that they are taught Darwinism in biology, but she doesn't believe it to be true and believes in Allah creating us from Adam and Hawa alayhi salam. I asked her, "Do you know about Piltdown Man?" She replied in negative. I explained her in this way. If a skull of human is compared with apes, there are two differences. First, the skull capacity of apes is smaller than humans, and the second, the apes have a slanting face. So if humans developed from apes, their intermediate form should have either a small skull capacity with a straight humanly face or a slanting face with normal human skull capacity. Of course, there are other differences too, but these are the main two criteria. Till date, such a fossil could not be unearthed that could fit in the intermediate form, and evolutionists wanted to prove human evolution in a hurry. So one paleontologist produced a hoax called Piltdown Man, which was shown to have a skull of large cerebral capacity with slanting jaw, and this was boasted by evolutionists as intermediate form between humans and apes. The said skull was kept in British Museum for 40 years as an intermediate between humans and apes and as a proof for human evolution. After 40 years, a new test called fluoride test was developed, and it was tried on that fossil skull to confirm its age. And then it was found to be very recent and consisting of an orangutan jaw and human skull, which were manipulated to fit in to make it look like belonging to each other. I asked that colleague of mine, suppose you were born in 1930s when the skull was there in British Museum, and you happened to visit that museum, and some guide would have told you that that was a specimen of a creature which was an intermediate between humans and apes. He also would have demonstrated you why it was an intermediate. Would you still have faith that you were a descendant of Adam and Hawa alayhi salam? The expression on her face changed suddenly and she almost exploded. Why do they teach us this if it is not true? And that's the end of this story. In our life, most of us are tried in our faith. How to keep our faith in Islam when something as important as science is giving evidence against it? When we study evolution, we are taught that it is the fact. So our faith shakes off from deep inside. We cannot think that there can be any different opinion on this matter in science too. We cannot think that we can be cheated in the name of science, or we are seeing the evidence from only one group of scientists. That's why we all must agree that it is the time of great trial for Muslims. Subhanallah. As much of supposed proof against creation and existence of God rests on proof of evolution, manipulations and mispresentations abound in this field of science. Piltdown Man was only one of them. A simple way of mispresentation is the excessive media coverage when any fossil is assigned as intermediate between humans and apes, but silence when the said fossil is labeled as only human or only ape. Many of us must have heard of Lucy, our supposed ancestor, but when was she declared as simple ape and not a human ancestor, no one knows. You need to follow up the literature and journals to know their destiny. The same happened to Nebraska Man and R.D. That's why we must learn to wait till the new evidence brought up in favor of human evolution collapses. Evolutionists don't want us to investigate in this matter. So they keep painting everything with the brush of evolution so that no one should be able to even doubt it. One will only investigate if there is suspicion. If something is taken as fact, no one will investigate it. That's why the lie is propounded as evolution is a fact, while it is not a fact. And with Allah is the guidance. May Allah keep our iman in His protection. Ameen.
نور في الظلمات أنسي في خلواتي يا سعدي وهنائي القرآن حياتي
نور ملأ القلب ففاض بحب كتاب الله
أشرق دربي بالقرآن فشكرا يا رباه
شكرا يا رباه.